Hi, this is Terry from True Marie Soap Works. Today I'm going to be showing you how I made this bar. It's a confetti soap and I used it from some of my soap left over from my previous batch. And I'm going to show you how I did that. Stay tuned to the end of my video and I'm going to talk a little bit about some pros to why I calculate my colorants and my batter so precisely. At the end of the video, as a thank you to you, I am going to let you pick my next batch. So I have a few options so you can just vote on which one you would like me to make next. I love learning about soap making, and if you're interested in learning along with me, just please give me a like and subscribe. And let's get started. When you're making confetti soap, it's best if you use the scraps of soap that's not very old and still very moist. You want your soap to be very similar to the new recipe you're making and not too dried out. I got the scraps from the previous batch, which was the marbling swirl, which was the technique number 18 video. And basically, these scraps are 2 days old. I made my soap and then I cut it and then I cut up the scraps and made the soap for this one. First, I need to find out the weight of the confetti I'm adding, so I have to cut everything up and then weigh it. I like the look of cubes in the soap. You can use confetti that is just grated and that will look fine too, but I've always liked the cubed look, so this is what I'm going for today. In order to figure out this batch, I first need to weigh all of my confetti, and then I need to do a little math to figure out what I need the weight of my next batch to be. To make a new recipe with the adjusted amount of soap, I'm going to need to find out how much oils are in this amount of confetti soap. And to do that, I need to figure out the percentage of oils that are in my soap. So we're going to go over to Soap Calc and I'm going to show you what I did to figure this out. Here I am in Soap Calc and this is just my normal 10 bar recipe. And this is my palm-free recipe, and I have everything already in, and this is a recipe like I use for my confetti, and it also has the same amount of water as a percentage of oils and super fat. Okay, so I go to my next screen, and which would be if you would calculate recipe and hit the viewer print tab, and here's my recipe. To figure out our new recipe, I'm going to type in here so you can have an idea of what I'm doing to figure this out. This is how to figure your new recipe. Okay, so we're gonna first take our oil weight divided by our batter weight. And that equals our oil percentage. Okay, so for this recipe, we take our oil weight, and it's also up here, oil weight, and we divide it by our batter weight. So that would be 33.5 divided by 46.59. And if you're doing grams, you would just take this number divided by this number and you get your percentage. So this equals 0.719. So that's your oil percentage. And now we need to figure out what percentage of oil we have in our weighed confetti soap. So confetti weight times oil percentage equals confetti oil weight. Okay, so that would be confetti weight is 6.8 ounces,
which you could use grams here.
It works the same way. So, and times your percentage, which is your 0.719, and that equals your confetti oil weight, which is 4.88. So I'm going to round that to 4.9. Okay, now that you have your amount of oil that's in your confetti, you need to subtract that from this number to get the remaining oil weight that you need. So we need to take our regular oil weight minus our confetti oil weight, and that equals our new batch oil weight. Okay, so that would be this 33.5 minus this confetti oil weight, which is 4.9, and that equals our new batter oil weight. So that is 28.6. Okay, now that we have that, we need to go back to our other tab and change this number to 28.6. And then we need to check this multiple tabs box and hit calculate recipe and go to viewer print recipe. And that gives you a new tab. And this is your new recipe. Okay, since we're here, I'm also going to show you how to figure your sodium lactate and your activated charcoal. And we'll start with the sodium lactate. And we'll be using that at a rate of 1 teaspoon per pound of oils. Okay, so that's a really simple one because we already know how many pounds of oils we have. So we just use this number, and this is how many teaspoons we use. So I'm going to round this up to 1.8 teaspoons. Okay, so for our activated charcoal, we'll do that next. I use a rate of 1.5 teaspoons per pound of soap. And this is also one that we could, for this recipe, since we're using it for the whole batch, we could just take this number of pounds of soap and multiply that by 1.5. But usually you can't do that because you're not using it for your whole batch. So I'm going to show you how to do this in the Elements Bath & Body's Colorant Calculator. So I go to Elements Bath & Body's Colorant Calculator, and to find that, you just go to elementsbathandbody.com, and you go to Explore, and you go under the Learning Center, you go to Calculators. And the colorant calculator is the last calculator you'll find on here. And the first part of it does per pound of soap, and the last part of it does per pound of oils. And in each of these, there's, if you're using a specific amount of batter, like say you're using 8 ounces of batter you want to color, you would use this one. But we are just using a percentage, so we are using this one. Okay, so we need to know this total weight of soap, so we have to go back to our recipe, and here we have our total weight of soap is 39.77, so we'll enter that here. Okay, and we're using 100% of our batter, so we put 100 there, and for our amount of recommended per pound of soap, we have 1.5, and you just hit calculate, and so your number right here is 3.728, and I would probably just round that to 3.75, so either you can use 3 teaspoons plus 3 quarters of a teaspoon, or you can use a tablespoon, which is 3 teaspoons, so 1 tablespoon and 3 fourths of a teaspoon. So you go back here, and you just put 3.75 teaspoons, or however you want to do it. Okay, so hopefully this helps you, and we'll get back to the tutorial.
I'm using distilled water ice cubes for a third to a half of my water weight, and then I just top off the remaining water weight with distilled water that's cold from the fridge. Next, I measure my sodium hydroxide, and you notice that my sodium hydroxide is in bead form, and there's also another kind of sodium hydroxide that is in flake form. I find that to decide which one you want to use, it kind of depends on where you live, because if you live in a place that's very dry, you kind of want to use the flakes, because the little beads tend to fly around if there's like statically in action if the air is really dry. And here in Indiana, I rarely have that problem. Maybe in the middle of winter sometimes, but usually more dry places like say Colorado or somewhere like that, you would maybe have better luck using the flakes. At this point, I also measure my sodium lactate, and sodium lactate is totally not necessary. You don't have to use it, and I just use it in mine because it does make a little bit of a harder bar, and it also helps your soap release from the mold easier. Next, I measure my coconut oil, and I get that melting. And while that's melting, I measure my liquid oils, and I start with my avocado oil, then my castor oil, and then my olive oil. I use a little squeeze bottle in between to top off the ingredients so I don't go over, because I don't want to have to take any out, because at this point they're mixed. I got this essential oil combination from a book by Benjamin Aaron, and it's a ebook, and it's called Essential Oil Blends for Handcrafted Soap. Ben so graciously allowed me to share this with you, so make sure and show him some love by going to Ben and Amanda's site. It's called Love and Soap Inc. They have a ton of resources there and a lot of ebooks, and also they are the ones that run the Facebook group called Saponification Nation, so between the two of them I've learned so much. And the essential oil combination is called Breath, and it uses a mixture of 20% of each of these essential oils. It's eucalyptus, rosemary, lavender, peppermint, and lemon. And this combination is very good if you want to have plenty of time to work. It doesn't cause acceleration. In fact, it kind of slows down trace. At this point, I added my liquid oils to my melted coconut oil, and then I measured in my cocoa butter pastilles. Next, I melt this in the microwave until it's just barely melted.
Next, I'm adding smooth coconut carbon, and this is from Elements Bath & Body, and it's also called activated charcoal. It's a little out of the ordinary for me to add my activated charcoal directly to my oils, but the reason I can do this, for one, is that I'm only using one color for my batter. Another reason is this is an awful lot to mix on my plexiglass with my palette knife. But if I were using this much titanium dioxide, you can bet I would mix this ahead of time because there would be a ton of specks if I do this the exact same way and just add it to my oils. Another reason is the particle size of activated charcoal is very small and it's very poofy. It's not clumpy, so it's an easy one to mix in. But if I was mixing in, like I said, titanium dioxide, that would be very clumpy. And you always see those streaks from when people cut their soap and their titanium dioxide isn't mixed in. Next, I add my essential oil combination to these oils and I just make sure that everything's blended in. Okay, now that the temperatures of my lye water and my oils have cooled down between 85 and 95 degrees Fahrenheit, I add my sodium lactate to my lye water. And then I just strain that into my oil solution. Then I stick blend until medium trace. I need my batter to be about at a medium trace because I need my confetti to just stay suspended in that batter because if it's that too thin of a trace, it would sink to the bottom. Remember that I'm using an essential oil combination that just really slows it down, so I had to do extra stick blending here than I normally would have to do to get it to medium trace. Once it's at medium trace, I pour about half of my batter into the mold. After I poured that, I poured a little extra into another pitcher. That will be my top. Next, I poured my remaining batter into my confetti and just stir that, but try not to introduce any air bubbles because this soap is kind of notorious for air bubbles. I picked a line a little right of the center and I poured it because I wanted my design to be kind of asymmetrical. So I just poured it there and let it spread out however it wants to. And then after I was done with that, I just topped it off with the remaining batter. When I finished this up, I covered it and I put it in a preheated oven that's preheated to the lowest temperature. Then when I put this in the oven, I turned the oven off and I turned the oven light on. And I have been starting to turn the oven light off at night before I go to bed and just let it come to room temperature in the oven and take it out in the morning and just leave it covered. And I actually left this in the mold for longer than I normally do because when I use embeds in soap, sometimes you get that little halo around the embed and also you get a little indentation where the embed was. So I was trying to avoid this and I did by leaving it in the soap mold for a little longer. I would say I did 4 days or so. Here I'm just touching up some of the air pockets that were in the top. Next I just use my vegetable peeler and I just bevel off each of the long edges. And now since I'm just cutting the soap and cleaning it, I'm going to tell you a little bit about what I would have done differently. And with this batch, I actually really was happy with how it came out. The only thing I probably would have done differently is just make sure and bang it down a little more because there were some air bubbles in there, which is very typical when you make a confetti soap. I love this process of making confetti soap and how it came out, so I feel like my final result looks like tumbled polished stones, and it just is gorgeous to me. So you know how you have that little extra bit of soap left over sometimes when you scrape it out of all your containers? I think just use those cut up. It looks so pretty, especially when there's kind of some interest to them, like some lines. So I might be making a lot more confetti soap. I'm also going to remember this when I have extra fragrances that I need to use or want to use. I have so many fragrances and I need to get through them and I just always think I need to just make these into soap. So this would be a great way to just make some of my fragrances into soap. Next, I'm going to tell you a little bit about why I calculate my colors so precisely. And also my batter, when I split it off, I split it off precisely. Well, what happens when you add a random amount of mica to your batter? You have to stick blend it in, and stick blending causes acceleration. Also, if it's not pre-diluted, it kind of absorbs water, and that makes it accelerate because it's taking some of that moisture to hydrate it. And that's one reason why I pre-mix my colorants. But say you pre-mix a certain amount of colorants and you just do a random amount. Well, a lot of times you make up too much colorant, which causes waste because you don't have anything to do with that, or you have to find a way to store it, which usually it's not enough to store, but it's not enough to make into something else, so it's wasted. Other times you might put too much of that into your soap and it could ruin your batch because you just have too much colorant. Other times you don't make up enough and then you're out of luck because you have to mix up some more. So the main reason why I like to calculate my colorants is because I have a record of what I did. Same with my batter. If I used a certain percentage, I know that if I like it, I can repeat it. If I don't like it, I can change my percentages until I get it right. And then when I get it right, I can just continue to do that. So with the colorants, you know, say my colorant was not dark enough, I know how much I use, so I know what to do to make it darker. Now that Elements Bath & Body has the colorant calculator, it's so easy. There's not a lot of math involved. You can just put in your amounts and it'll give you the answer. You don't have to set up proportions. You don't have to do math. So what I'm saying is if you have a rate that you know you used, you can increase it or decrease it. Or if you like it, you can keep it the same. But if you don't know what you used, you have no starting point for next time when you want to change that color. So it's important to keep good notes, and that way you can learn from yourself by trial and error. I'm taking a poll to see which one of these designs you would like me to do next. I will just leave the voting open until the end of Sunday so I can get started on it on Monday. So please just vote A, B, C, or D. Whichever technique wins, I will be doing that technique, but I will be changing up the design a little bit and also changing up the colors. If you're finding these videos helpful and you still want to learn more, I have a soap making group that I started on Facebook, and it is for asking questions and for sharing, and we troubleshoot and just encourage each other in soap making. So if you're interested in that, I have a link in my description of how to get to that group, and then you just ask to join, and please ask to join under your personal Facebook name and not your business name. If you're looking for inspiration, on my webpage I have my gallery, and there's lots of soaps there to look at. And also, I have my shop there, so if you want to take a look. I really appreciate those of you that placed orders last week. Thank you so much. If you appreciate these videos, please give me a thumbs up. And if you're new to my channel and you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe and hit the bell for notifications. And feel free to share my videos with your soap making friends. Thank you so much for joining me, and have a great day.